Hello and welcome to the guided pain body release visualization exercise. Firstly, let's define a pain body. I will use the definition of Eckhart Tolle here for this purpose. The pain body is my term for the accumulation of old emotional pain that almost all people carry in their energy field. I see it as a semi-autonomous psychic entity. It consists of negative emotions that were not faced, accepted, and then let go in the moment they arose. Now I will let Eckhart explain a very important point about identifying pain body attacks that he made in a chat with Oprah.
And usually it's the pain body when the emotional reaction is out of proportion to the triggering event. So a relatively minor thing triggers an enormous amount of unhappiness in whatever form.
And so this is the way you can tell whether or not it's a pain body instead of a reaction to something that's actually happening. It is unlikely that you have come to this guided practice in the middle of a pain body attack, because when our pain body is fully active, the stories are being completely believed, and there is no space between us and them to begin to let go of them. However, if you have indeed come to this in the middle of an attack, then you are exhibiting a high degree of awareness of your own behavior. But most of us are here because the nagging stories and corresponding emotional states have not gone away, and we feel trapped in a pain body loop and are conscious enough to want out. Either way, please be patient with yourself during this process. Let us begin. The pain body is comprised of four separate elements, which often feel like one process, but they are not. When we break them into their individual component parts, they lose cohesive power, and we are able to find space from or heal each one separately. The four parts are: Part 1, the emotional state running through your body right now. Part 2, the conditioned limbic system response, emotional center of your brain, that is feeding off the stimulus to get blood flow, and therefore strengthen its neural net and its hold over your life. Part 3, an inner child locked in the unresolved state that was conjured by the stimuli and now sits unheld and unhealed, feeling vulnerable and lost in a perpetual cage of darkness. Part 4, a story that the limbic system is using to keep the pain body re-triggering, to stay in a loop where it gets to feed more at the body's expense and at the expense of your life and those around you. We are going to unravel your pain body one component at a time, and in doing so, you should find great relief in the form of space between you and the active components. We are going to do them in the order of impact rather than the order stated before. This gives us a gradual reduction of suffering as we go along. And here we go. 1. Drop the story. There is a story running right now that is often either a victim or deficiency story. It's time to let it go by simply noting it and not bringing it into ourselves. This process, often called mindfulness, reminds us that we are the awareness of the event and not the event itself. The story is an event moving across our awareness, and it's time, by simply noting its existence, that we begin to let it go. These stories are very often not very creative and take on some predictable forms. They did this or that to me. I am not worthy of love or happiness. Things will never get better. I never get what I want. The past has always been horrible to me. Or the future is dangerous to me in some way. While these might not be the exact stories going on in your mind, they are very common stories, and you might find components of them in the stories that are now running. This is not the time to debate the truth or untruth of these stories. They may, indeed, in the relative, be true. This is a time to see that there is a story that is part of my pain body experience. Begin by noticing that in this now moment, other than the emotional and physical discomfort, there is no threat happening. We know this because if we were indeed in the midst of some challenge, we would not have time to be doing this exercise. There is an emotional state, but there is no direct threat to me in this now moment. Any threats in these stories are threats happening to some abstract mental image of myself, in the form of some character in the story of my suffering. But I am here and now. I am the awareness experiencing the state and the stories. Move your sense of self for the moment to the awareness and away from the abstract character in your mind's repetitive stories. Again, we are not debating whether or not the stories are true or false, simply that in this now moment, they are merely stories and not reality, which is now. Take a moment to move your sense of self out of the stories and into the present moment awareness. Do this now. Pause this recording if needed before moving on. Okay, now. 2. If you have successfully dropped the story, stay vigilant, because your mind is going to change it to another one. Okay, you've seen through the story, and you are the present moment awareness. Be vigilant, because the mind won't give up that easily. Be aware as it attempts to change the story to continue its pain body attack. For instance, if you see through the story, they did this or that to me, wait a moment, because your mind might try, everyone always does this to me, etc. It is very important to remember that if the mind is changing stories, it doesn't take the story seriously in the first place. If the story were so important, the mind would not so easily discard it and move on to another one. So now that you have seen your mind moves from story to maintain your pain body attack, ask yourself, if the mind doesn't actually take the stories it tells seriously, why should I take them seriously? Anchor yourself in the awareness and let the events pass. Stay vigilant and notice as we continue this process all the new stories it attempts to sell you to stay in the pain body loop. If you wish, get out a notepad and write them down. But once you have them down, come back to awareness and continue the process. Do this now. Pause this recording, if needed, before moving on. 3. Pick up and hold your inner child. Inside of you is a much younger version of yourself trapped in the same emotional state you are in right now. Your pain body attack is using its unhealed wounds to poke and prod to stay in the loop. Now that the story is dropped, it is time to gently pick up that child and move it out of the process. Bring the child to the present moment where there are no threats. Or, if you like, envision a very safe parental figure, an actual parent or guardian, a guru, a teacher, a historical spiritual figure like Christ or Buddha, a therapist, anybody that you trust completely, and pass your child over to them for safekeeping. Visualize that safe parent holding and guarding your inner child as you turn to face the remaining components of the pain body attack. If you are able to generate space yourself, then you can be this for your own child. Either one works. Take them out of this process and to safety before moving on to the last step. Don't rush them. Remember, they are locked in an unresolved emotional state. Give them time to wind down from this. With perfect awareness, this process takes 90 full seconds, and more if the emotion is re-triggered by falling back into the spell of another cycle of pain body stories. Wait until they feel safe in the arms of the protected parental figure before you move on. There is no hurry. Pause this recording if you need more time, and do this now. 4. Find the real culprit and hold it accountable. Not every brain mechanic in our heads has our best interest in mind. They are all necessary functions, but some have grown out of control and need to generate useless and untrue drama and stress to maintain their bloated size. These are living cells, and most of them do not have empathy or compassion. If, through many years of overstimulation, they have grown out of control, they are convinced that they are needed, even when they are now causing pain and suffering. However, bloated and overfed, they are no longer effectively helping us function day to day. They are certain of their importance and will use any trick, method, or lie to get our attention, because where we place our attention, the brain sends blood flow and feeds these processes. The more these processes have been fed, the more drama and stress it needs to create to maintain its size and dominance, and is poking our bleeding wounds right now. One of those centers is the language center and storytelling mechanisms in our mind, and we used awareness at the beginning of this process to get some space from them. Now it's time to move to the nonverbal components and notice them. Be cautious, because this is a good time for one of the favorite stories to arise from these brain mechanics now that you are aware of them, and that is the story, "I'm here to help." If the processes were so helpful, they would not be debilitating and painful. This story is an outright lie. This is not to say that these brain mechanics aren't convinced of their necessity. I'm just here to tell you, they are not helping. If this story arises, use the same mindfulness technique mentioned before to gain space from it before moving on to noticing the brain mechanics non-verbally. Something in our own brain wants this process to continue. Something inside of our brain is dining on a nice all-you-can-eat buffet of blood flow at the expense of your peace, joy, and love. And it's time to notice it directly. It doesn't like to be looked at, so it will hide. Look at it anyway. Simply watch as it gets very upset now that we have become conscious of it. And just hold your attention on it. It feeds when you look away, when you are unconscious. We're going to stay conscious and just watch as it squirms and uses the language center to continue. Don't join it. Simply watch it and remain as awareness. You can feel it squirm. You can feel it trying to get away from your attention. You can feel it as it tries to change subject matters, tries to threaten you in some way. Just keep watching it. Do this until it goes back into hiding completely, which it will if you just sit and don't engage and just look at it. Don't rush this. It's a crafty little thing, and it will hide for a moment and hope we become unconscious again. Stay with it for a good minute after it subsides. Then, when you are done, know for certain that it is looking for an opportunity to return and take over your experience. Once finished, stay in conscious awareness and abide in the self of the now. Much love to you.